بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
تقبل الله منا ومنكم، عيد مبارك علينا وعليكم. تقبل الله منا ومنكم، عيد مبارك علينا وعليكم.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، والله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد.
استقيموا، استووا، تراصوا، أقبلوا على الله بقلوبكم. Straighten the lines, close the gaps. الله أكبر. الله أكبر، 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 الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض، وإن تبدوا ما في أنفسكم أو تخفوه يحاسبكم به الله، فيغفر لمن يشاء ويعذب من يشاء، والله على كل شيء قدير. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون، كل آمن بالله، كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله، وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا، غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها، لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت، ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا، ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا، ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به، واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا، أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد اللهم لك الحمد أنت نور السماوات والأرض ومن فيهن ولك الحمد أنت قيوم السماوات والأرض ومن فيهن ولك الحمد أنت ملك السماوات والأرض ومن فيهن ولك الحمد أنت الحق وقولك حق ووعدك حق ولقاؤك حق والساعة حق والجنة حق والنار حق والنبيون حق ومحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم حق اللهم لك أسلمنا وبك آمنا وعليك توكلنا وبك خاصمنا وإليك حاكمنا فاغفر لنا ما قدمنا وما أخرنا وما أسررنا وما أعلنا وما أنت أعلم به منا أنت المقدم وأنت المؤخر لا إله إلا أنت إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره
ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Eid Mubarak to all of you. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the glorified, the exalted, by the virtues of His beautiful names and lofty attributes, to accept your siyam, to accept your qiyam, to accept your sadaqah, your recitation of the Quran, and all other acts of worship you volunteered in this month. Brothers and sisters in Islam, قال صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم للصائم فرحتان يفرحهما فرحة عند فطره وفرحة عند لقاء ربه. The fasting Muslim will have two moments of joy. The first one is today, which you experienced a peak of it every day throughout the month of Ramadan. When you're about to break your fast, you feel that joy that you were able to defeat yourself in submission to your Lord. And this is the whole objective behind fasting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is enabling you, granting you the strength and the power to defeat yourselves. Our own selves is the first enemy in our path to submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah held us out throughout the month by chaining the shayateen, the maradatil jinn, the rebellious of the jinn, by giving us the incentive, the collective, the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in congregations. A lot of Muslims normally would make it to the masjid throughout the month of Ramadan. So this is a day of joy. Today, the servitude of joy, that you're happy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala referred to this in the verses of fasting in Surah Al-Baqarah, when he said subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهِ. That's what you've been doing since sunset yesterday. Takbirat. To glorify Allah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illa Allah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Walillahi alhamd. ولتكبر الله. You glorifying Allah, magnifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, exalting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For what? ولتكبر الله على ما هداكم. That He guided you. He guided you to fast. He guided you to submit to Him. How many Muslims are there who have not done what you have done? How many Muslims are there? How many non-Muslims have not even found their way to Islam yet? You should glorify and exalt Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the bounty of Islam to begin with. Add to this glorifying and magnifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guiding you to submit and fulfill the third pillar of Islam, fasting, the fourth pillar of Islam, fasting the month of Ramadan. Brothers and sisters in Islam, وَلِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. Also, that you are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guiding you and strengthening you to do so. But brothers and sisters in Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that the second moment of joy is not here in this world. وَلِلصَّائِمِ فَرْحَتَانِ يَفْرَحُهُمَا. The fasting person, the fasting Muslim, is entitled to two moments of joy. One of them is today, the day of Eid, and he experienced a peak of it every day throughout the month of Ramadan. But the second moment of joy, عِنْدَ لِقَاءِ رَبِّي. When you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of resurrection, Ya Allah, Look at this. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, والحديث أخرجه الشيخان من حديث أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه, Look what fasting will do for you. Look what fasting will do for you. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, من صام يوما في سبيل الله باعد الله بذلك اليوم وجهه عن النار 70 خريفا. Whosoever fast one day, whether voluntary, whether mandatory, sincerely في سبيل الله, means sincerely, إيمانا, what will happen يا رسول الله؟ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will distance the face of this person, the distance of 7 years from the hellfire. Subhanallah. One day, you fasted 30 days. Regardless whether 29 or 30, it's counted as 30 days Ramadan. Look at the second virtue. Look at what the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is referring, why you will be joyful in the day of resurrection. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the day of resurrection is a day when you will be alone. No one cares about you. Even your own family members. يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ, the day on which a brother will flee from another brother. وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ, his mother and his father. وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ, his wife and his kids, his children. لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ شَأْنٌ يُغْنِيهِ, everyone will be so occupied with himself. Look at the other one. يُبَصَّرُونَهُمْ, you will see your family members in the day of resurrection. يَوَدُّ الْمُجْرِمْ لَوْ يَفْتَدِي مِنْ عَذَابِ يَوْمِئِذٍ بِبَنِيهِ. Imagine a father who is transgressing with love to ransom himself from the punishment, from the chastisement in the day of resurrection by paying his children as a ransom. No one knows you. Subhanallah. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, look on this day. والحديث أخرجه الحاكم في المستدرك وقال على شرط مسلم من حديث عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنهما, الصيام والقيام يشفعان للعبد يوم القيامة. Imagine the fasting you did, the Quran you recited in the day of resurrection will be transformed into a material form, into material form. It will have a material image and it will stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to intercede on your behalf. يقول الصيام, the fasting will say, أي رب, يا رب, منعته الطعام والشراب والشهوة, I deprived him from eating, from drinking, from taking care of his privates, the relationship with one spouse. شفعني في يا رب, allow me, give me the permission to intercede on his behalf. يقول القرآن, the Quran will say, أي رب, I منعته النوم بالليل, I deprived him from sleeping at night, يا رب, شفعني فيه, allow me to intercede on his behalf. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, فيشفعان, they will be granted this status. This is why you will be joyful in the day of resurrection. Add to this حديث أبي العباس سهل بن سعد الساعدي رضي الله عنه والحديث في الصحيحين. Look, brothers and sisters in Islam, nations will be kneeling. People will be kneeling in the land of gathering in the day of resurrection. And then by all the sudden, a caller will call, أين الصائمون؟ أين الصائمون؟ Where are those who used to fast in the dunya? Stand up, enter Jannah from a gate called the Rayyan. You enter Jannah from that gate. In the wording of Ibn Khuzaymah, you will be given a drink, you will never be thirsty afterwards. For this is, you're entitled to joy today, the lawful joy. And inshaAllah, nas'Allah al-Azim, Rabb al-Arsh al-Kareem, an yarzuqana yawm al-qiyamah, to bestow upon us, on the day of resurrection, the second moment of joy. Brothers and sisters in Islam, شرعت الأعياد في ديننا لتقوية أواصر المسلمين. The wisdom behind legislating أعياد, those 2 days, عيد الفطر وعيد الأضحى, to strengthen the bonds amongst us. That is why we're supposed today to dress the best way we can.
We're supposed to smell the best way we can. We're supposed to come out here today and smiling at the face of one another, regardless where he's from, regardless what language he speaks. He's your Muslim brother, and you're supposed to say Eid Mubarak. This is where your Muslim brother and sister. This is the wisdom, the divine wisdom behind legislating A'yad. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this is a day also when we must make up with our family members. We know throughout the year, we may have caused some damage to our kinship ties. We may have, all of us, listen, we're all human. You may have wronged your relatives. You may have. You know what? They may have wronged you. Today you're supposed to make up. Today you're supposed to forgive. Brothers and sisters in Islam, you know, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam told us that on Laylatul Qadr, call upon Allah al-Afu, call upon Allah, the one who pardons, the one who wipes away the sins, the one who erases everything. Now, if you want al-Afu, if you want the one who erases your sins, if you want him to erase yours, to wipe, to overlook your shortcomings, why don't you overlook and pardon others? Why? You want Allah? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, once it came to the attribute of mercy, he connected the two. He said to the companions, "Man la yarham la yurham." Whosoever is not showing mercy to others, he will not be showing mercy by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وقال حديث عبد الله بن عمرو ارحموا من في الارض يرحمكم من في السماء. Be merciful to those who are in the earth, the one in the heavens will be merciful to you. Likewise, be pardoning, be forgiving. If you want the one in the heavens to pardon you, to forgive you. Brothers and sisters in Islam, wallahi, I read this verse and you reflect, if you reflect upon it, it's out of this world. Look at this verse. Look at this verse. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنَّ مِنْ أَزْوَاجِكُمْ وَأَوْلَادِكُمْ عَدُوًّا لَكُمْ فَاحْذَرُوهُمْ. Oh, ye who believe, some of your, look, children, the closest to you, spouses, enemies, they are your enemies. Allah is telling you that your wife, your child are your enemies. Be careful, watch out. Is the verse over? No, it's not over. That's half. Look at the second half. وَإِن تَعْفُوا وَتَصْفَحُوا وَتَغْفِرُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. What should you do in the face of that animosity? In the face, pardon, overlook, forgive. Imagine, can you do that? Wallahi is a sign of strength. During the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there was a companion whose name is Thumamah ibn Uthal. Rajul kan king, he was a king, Sayyid Bani Hanifa. You know, tribal system in the peninsula, that if you're a leader of a tribe, that means you're like a president of a country. He was an enemy of Islam and Muslims. He was living in the vicinity of Yemen. And he told his tribesmen that whenever you hunt a Muslim, kill him. Bring him to me, kill him. He killed some of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam instructed his companions, well, hadith al-sahihain, hadith Abi Hurairah, instructed his companions to capture him and bring him alive to me. He killed so many of my companions. So they did. They caught him. He was on his way to perform Umrah. Umrah is one of the rituals of Sayyidina Ibrahim in Sha'air al-Hanifiyya. They brought him to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Imagine what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did to him. He tied him, look at the humiliation, in one of the pillars of the masjid. He took him inside the masjid and he found the pillar with a rope and he tied him. Imagine you're tying a president, a leader of a tribe like this. And he came to him and he looked to him. ما عندك يا ثمامة؟ What can you say about this situation, يا ثمامة? What do you think I'm gonna do to you? You know what he said to him? يا محمد, يا محمد, أو محمد, إن تقتل تقتل ذا دم. If you kill me, I'm expensive. My tribesmen are gonna come after you for my blood. They will come after you. They will not let you go. وَإِن تُرِدِ الْمَالِ, if you want ransom, if you want money for the people I killed, سَلْ تُعْطَى. Ask, you name the amount. You name. If you want ransom for the people I killed from your companions, I'm willing to ransom. وَإِن تَعْفُوا تَعْفُوا عَنْ شَاكِرٍ. But if you pardon me, if you let me go, you're gonna find me grateful. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam ignored him and he left. He came back the second day to him. He looked at him and he asked him the same question. ما عندك يا ثمامة? What do you say يا ثمامة? قال ما قلت لك. What I told you yesterday. إن تقتل تقتل ذا دم وإن ترد المال سلتعطى وإن تعفو تعفو عن شاكر. He repeated the same exact words he repeated yesterday. The third day, the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to him and he asked him the same question. ما عندك يا ثمامة? Anything new? He said, لا, ما, nothing new. The same thing. If you kill, my tribesmen are going to come after you. If you want money as ransom for your companions, then I'm willing to pay it. And if you let me go, you're going to find me grateful. Guess what? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did the one that you never expect. قال أطلقوا ثمامة. Let ثمامة go. Release him. He released him. He left town. He went to the outskirts of Medina. He found the wheel. And he came back to the masjid. And he stood in front of the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله والله يا رسول الله. Imagine he used to say, Ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, look, Wallahi ya Rasul Allah, by Allah, O Messenger of Allah, ما كان وجه على وجه الأرض أبغض إلي من وجهك. There was no face in the face of this earth more resented, hated by me than your face. Wallahi ya Rasul Allah, by Allah, O Messenger of Allah, ما وجه على وجه الأرض أحب إلي من وجهك. Now there is no face in the face of this earth more beloved to me than your face. Wallahi ya Rasul Allah, by Allah, O Messenger of Allah, ما كان دين على وجه الأرض أبغض إلي من دينك. There was no other religion more resented by me than your religion. Now your religion is the most beloved religion to me. Your town, ما كان بلد المدينة, more resented to me than your town. Now المدينة is the most beloved place to me. Look, وإني كنت ذاهبا إلى العمرة, and I was in my way to Mecca to perform Umrah. مرني يا رسول الله, command me, O Messenger of Allah, what to do. He said, اذهب, go and perform your Umrah. When he entered Mecca, like I said a minute ago, that Umrah and Hajj from the rituals of Ibrahim. Ibrahim originally, alayhi salam, is the one introduced. But the Quraysh added, they invented, innovated, especially with the Talbiyah. So when he entered Mecca to perform Umrah, he said, لبيك اللهم لبيك, لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك, إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك. And he stopped. The Qurayshi, the polytheists, the disbelievers added one more sentence. إِلَّا شَرِيكًا تَمْلِكُهُ وَلَا يَمْلُكُ. هذه بدعة. بدعة. Added it. So when the Qurayshi heard him not making their بدعة, أصبأت يا ثمامة? Did you become a disbeliever يا ثمامة? قال بل أسلمت. By Allah, his province was the source where the Quraysh would get their wheat and their barley. والله لا تأتيكم حبة حنطة من اليمامة حتى يأذن بها رسول الله. I'm not going to export you any more wheat, corn, or barley until the Messenger of Allah commands me to do so. Why did Thumama do this? In ta'fu, ta'fu an shakir. And if you pardon, I'll be grateful. This is what we need to do, brothers and sisters in Islam. Khud al-af. This is the day. Even if you were wronged, especially kinship ties, brothers and sisters in Islam. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ليس الواصل بالمكافئ. You upholding your kinship ties is not by paying back the visit, is not calling back after you've been called. No, you know what upholding kinship ties is? That your relative boycotts you and you call him. He doesn't want to talk to you and you call him. He doesn't want you to visit him, you go and visit him. Do this, brothers and sisters in Islam. Please your Lord, this is a day when we're supposed to strengthen and fasten these bonds amongst the Muslims. Because I'm telling you, there is no way the work of Islam will be done on the shoulders of individuals. The work of Islam is done on the shoulder of a community. And that community must love one another, must care for one another. Brothers and sisters in Islam, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, والذي نفسي بيده, by the one in whose hand my soul is, لن تدخل الجنة حتى تؤمنوا. You will never enter Jannah unless you believe. ولن تؤمنوا حتى تحابوا. And you will never attain that perfect faith. Perfect faith. الإيمان التام. Not الإيمان الواجب. The perfect faith. Unless you love one another. ألا أدلكم على شيء إذا فعلتموه تحاببتم. Shall I direct you to an act if you do and stick to? You will love one another. أفشوا السلام بينكم. Spread peace. Not just the word, the spirit. That I look at my brother, I feel secure from you. I look at my sister, I feel secure from her. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم المسلم من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده. The true Muslim, beside observing the five pillars of Islam, but there is another definition that has to do with the character. The true Muslim is the one whom the rest of the Muslims feel secure from his tongue and from his hand. This is the true definition of Islam. For this is a day of bond. This is a day of connecting. Brothers and sisters in Islam, in closing, a spirit of despair is out there. What's happening in the Muslim world? The killing, the defeat. There is a spirit out there in the air. You can sense it. You're naive if you do not see it. People are beginning to lose confidence. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hinted to this in the Quran. Just read the verse before last in Surah Yusuf. Look what Allah says. حتى إذا استيأس الرسل وظنوا أنهم قد كذبوا جاءهم نصرنا. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would test the believers so much to the extent that they begin despairing. They begin despairing. And they begin doubting some of the fundamentals. What? إِنَّا لَنَنْصُرُ رُسُلَنَا. Allah says, I will give victory to my messengers. كَذَلِكَ حَقًّا عَلَيْنَا نُنْجِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. كَذَلِكَ حَقًّا عَلَيْنَا نَصْرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. The believers are entitled to my victory. Don't despair, brothers and sisters in Islam. It's a matter of time. Look at an ummah. Abu Bakr, Umar, عثمان علي رضي الله عنهم جميعا are the beginning. I'll look at the ummah, the end of it is al-Imam Muhammad ibn Abdullah al-Mahdi according to Ahl al-Sunnah and Isa ibn Maryam. That have not happened yet. This will happen in the future. We're just being tested. We're just being tested. أم حسبتم أن تدخلوا الجنة ولما يأتكم مثل الذين خلوا من قبلكم مستهم البأساء والضراء وزلزلوا وزلزلوا. Those who before us, they were shaken. حتى يقول الرسول والذين آمنوا معه. To the extent that the messenger and those who followed him, those who believed with him would say, متى نصر الله? When is the victory of Allah? It's coming. But for that victory to come, we must reform. You see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted you the month of Ramadan to train yourself to that reform. You kept up with that tight, demanding schedule. You deprived yourselves from basic needs, food and water, in obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what you need to carry on doing. But differently, you need to keep up with your 5 daily prayers. You need to stay away from the haram and carry on obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you do this and you get your family to do this, that change will happen. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Allah will never change our conditions unless we as individuals do make the change. The ummah is waiting for you to make the change. Don't just wait for victory to come when you're still not out there. The Muslims lost the battle of Uhud because they disobeyed one command. One command, they lost the whole battle. One command. They were commanded to stand in a certain location and not to leave that location. They decided to do it. That's why they lost the battle. Walk into the houses of Muslims now. Walk into the streets of Muslims and see how many disobediences are there. We gotta remove that. We gotta take care of that for the change to happen. Brothers and sisters in Islam, in closing, and I really mean it this time. Subhanallah, don't ever worry about what happens to you in this world. Wallahi ya ikhwa, it doesn't matter. I always tell my brothers and sisters who speak with that spirit of despair, I tell him, ya akhi, just keep up with your obligations. وكلها 60 70 سنة والموضوع حيخلص يعني. It's just 60 70 years and will be done inshallah. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the lifespan of my ummah is between 60 and 70. Yeah, there are some who will cross. But imagine 60 70 years and Jannah is waiting for you. Jannah. You see, what awaits you is far better than what you're going through. I want to rescue you from the sun. I love you all for the sake of Allah. This is a beautiful community, the community of Al-Minhal. I want to let you know that, inshallah, beginning the month of October, we will be having the Islamic studies program, the Arabic program. There are forms out there that you need to register, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Please, let's love one another for the sake of Allah. Let's stand for the work of Islam. Al-Minhal is a place where we can protect our ummah and protect our children. Eid Mubarak to all of you, and I love you all for the sake of Allah. Please stand up and give the brothers a hug, and don't forget to call your family members overseas. If you need help to buy a phone card, we can provide that for you. جزاكم الله خيرا.
تقبل الله منا ومنكم عيد مبارك علينا وعليكم. تقبل الله منا ومنكم عيد مبارك علينا وعليكم. صمنا أياما أحلى الأيام يا ربي أعدها كل الأعوام. صمنا أياما أحلى الأيام يا ربي أعدها كل الأعوام. وفاز كل من صلى وصام. فجئت يا عيد بالخير والبشرى فأنت لنا اليوم فرحتنا الكبرى. فجئت يا عيد بالخير والبشرى فأنت لنا اليوم فرحتنا الكبرى. تجمع الأحباب لنصنع الفجر. تقبل الله منا ومنكم تقبل الله منا ومنكم، عيد مبارك علينا وعليكم،
باتحاد وإخاء وقلوب صادقات ووفاء ليس تنفيه سنون،
تلتقي آياتنا كل عام بثبات نحو خير نحو مجد المسلمين، باتحاد وإخاء وقلوب صادقات ووفاء ليس تنفيه السنون،
تلتقي أعيادنا كل عام بثبات نحو خير نحو مجد المسلمين،
تقبل الله منا ومنكم عيد مبارك علينا وعليكم، تقبل الله منا ومنكم عيد مبارك علينا وعليكم،
كل الخلافات يمضي بها العيد، تدنو المسافات تحلو المواعيد،
كل الخلافات يمضي بها العيد، تدنو المسافات تحلو المواعيد،
تدنو المسافات تحلو المواعيد،
أبهجت يا عيد أحزان ماضينا، أعادك الله عزا وتمكينا، أبهجت يا عيد أحزان ماضينا، أعادك الله عزا وتمكينا،
أعادك الله عزا وتمكينا،
تقبل الله منا ومنكم عيد مبارك علينا وعليكم، 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 تقبل الله منا ومنكم عيد مبارك علينا وعليكم.